I just got Bocash today with
me. Hey, everybody.
All right, and today we're going to start with the Mad Max Bart level. Yeah, this is the motorcycle one from before, and this is the one where I left out the most important control element in my first blind run of this. The control element being, if you tap the L and R buttons, you'll kick to the side. Very, very important for this level. Nidoking once again coming to my rescue. Yeah, definitely the most important thing you pointed out. Now, yeah, we're going to see me do the level in two runs here, because once you run out of health, you're out. There's no free lives. You just go back into the overworld. And the basic goal is to just pass the gates to get your time extended and get to the end without taking all the damage. I probably could have done it in one complete run, but I didn't quite manage it, so I go back to the outer world. Whether I get a checkpoint, I think I must have, because in my second run it seemed pretty short. Once I get ejected, I'll come back and finish it. So the level, yeah, it bombards you with enemies. It's pretty tough. But if you can tank some of them, you can pass them, you can kick them, those are good strategies. If you can throw your little tomato gun at them, shoot them, or with water balloons from afar, that's good too. You get them out of the way before they come at you. So here we're going to finish it. It's a nice quick level, so we'll get to another one before the end of this video.
Oh, okay, too. Mm-hmm. The depth in this seems really bad. I mean, the enemy sizes they seem to be equally as large as they are close as they are far away.
Yeah, welcome to the horrible use of Mode 7 graphics once again. Perspective goes out the window for this level. I think they might have just used the same thing, same graphics that they used and sprites and everything for the tomato throwing level, for the class photo level, because yeah, when they're farther away they're larger, and when they're closer they're smaller. Sometimes it's really effed up. Check out when the school bus comes at you. The school bus, when it's far away, is bigger than it is when it's closer. It makes no sense. We'll definitely get a look at that. Yeah, so pay attention to the school bus. But yeah, basically, you just gotta make your way through the enemies. Either tank them, pass them, shoot them before they get to you, or kick them with the L and R. I don't know how I didn't figure that out in my first run.
Just waste those bitches.
Mm-hmm. I don't know how I didn't get that kick on my first try on this, because I played a lot of Road Rage, and I was looking for the kick, and I just, you know, didn't think L or R.
The bus is bigger.
Yep, there you go.
Look at that, it shrinks.
It shrinks. Very weird. It's hard to get over that. It's a really jarring effect.
Man, this is quite a quite a deep topic, you know. Apocalyptic nuclear future.
That's right. It's the end of the world, and you're the last one alive. That's pointed out in the victory cutscene. I want to bring it up quickly because it's so short. Pay close attention to the victory cutscene. It's got some of the best voice rendering I've ever heard. Oh man, when I asked them to make full sentences, here you go.
Just in time!
Hey, surviving kids!
So, I don't know, I guess they couldn't make full sentences.
Yeah.
Just one word at a time, that's all you get. So that's it, all the levels done. And we're, except on that half of the level scoreboard, gonna jump into the worst level of the game. Baby Bart. So once again, I had to do a lot of editing for this. Definitely going to change the audio, but there is more music in this level.
Level is terrible.
It's terrible. It's got, like I said, really hard controls. The platforming gets way worse as we move on. It expects you to do things that are really crazy, and you can tell in the level design that they just didn't even care about the player. They were like, okay, we'll just set this up so that you're required to take a shitload of damage, and then we'll put a little bit of health at the end, so once they're forced to take damage, they can collect health again. It's really stupid. It's a terrible idea. And I'd failed a lot. You saw me take a couple deaths and hop back up on the tree. Lots of save stating in this level. Up until now, I've only been using the save state after I beat a level to ensure that I don't get a game over and can continue on my progress. I have failed the levels a few times, especially the pig level. But for this one, all that went out the window, and I just save stated at any safe moment. You're gonna see a lot of all that cut out, though. I just showed that earlier so that You knew I was doing save states, so just get that out of the way, get that out in the open. But you won't see them again, it's just going to be the successful ones. So once again, another vital piece of controls that was pointed out to me by Nidoking that I wouldn't have been able to beat the game without. When you hold down a bunch of buttons, I found the best way to do it was to hold down A, B, X, and Y. I think you can do it just by holding down two of them. But if you hold down some buttons, Bart's diaper comes out like that, goes upside down, and you get a parachute. Get some failed save state.
Ugh. Oh, but at least that's a checkpoint, yeah.
Yep, took a death there, got the checkpoint. I'm gonna keep on going. Yeah, I used so many save states for this that I didn't even bother going back out into the overworld. You get a few free men. I collected one earlier. So here's the clothesline portion. If you touch any of those clothing articles, you'll fall to your death. You can jump over them, or you can go down or up to a different clothesline to avoid them. In the meantime, many things there are going to try to reduce your health to zero. I was disappointed I couldn't get that health. The screen is scrolling by itself.
Oh, that's such a hassle.
So I have no health to continue on right here, so it's another time where I have to take the checkpoint. So right off the bat, we're losing our lives. So you continue from the end of the clothesline once you've made it to. It's pretty nice. Then you go on to this part where you're avoiding... Oh, really horribly rendered dogs. They look... Oh my god.
How do you dodge that dog? It's swinging all the way to the top.
I messed up. You gotta contra it. You jump and shoot down. And I didn't figure out how to jump until they placed a life saying, jump, idiot. And I still didn't do it until afterwards. So another missed life. Pretty easy to have gotten, but I didn't need it because we're using save states. And we have a new portion of the level that's kind of fun. We are now in the turbo tunnel.
With the baby bullies.
There's way more sections to this level than any other level.
Yeah, this level has way more sections. It just goes on and on. Okay, yeah. Baby bullies in their little strollers. You got yours. It's a nicer one. They're poor. They're in like shopping carts or something. You can take them out and then just do the rest of it by yourself. Wasn't that difficult, actually. It's actually nothing compared to the turbo tunnel. There are no ramps, no jumps. You do move by yourself, but not nearly as fast. You can avoid everything. You can take a lot of damage. You don't die in one hit. And we move on to the final screens of the level. Actually, that's not true. Holy crap. This level goes on for even longer than I thought. This would have taken me a really long time to show everyone if I'd showed you all of my failed attempts and load states. This is ridiculous. It's because of the phases of the seals with their balls coming up. You can't make these jumps properly. You have to abuse some...
What?
You have to abuse some kind of broken jumping thing that's in the game, where if you land on it with your head, you'll bounce, even if it's too far down. There's also a bounce you can do on the ball if you tap the A button at the right time, or the B button. But it's hard to time, and it's definitely the worst part. Those things... There were not enough save states to get me through it. That was very difficult.
Is it possible to land on the balls that the seals are holding up even when they're not visible below the fence?
Somehow I was
only
able
if
to...
if your head is down.
Yeah, somehow I was able to abuse the diaper parachute to land on seals that weren't even visible. Now we're in the final section of the level. And really, you're not given any indication as to where to go, so it's a lot of guessing and jumping down again. It's just the worst kind of level design. And this is what I was talking... Oh, yeah, so you get these ropes. And this is what I was talking about, where you have to take damage, and then they just conveniently place health here. You land anywhere there, you take damage. Alright, let's go. It's pretty tough to tell where to go, I find, just in this level. This part of the level has no real hint. You just go up these and you go down. Hope you land on a trampoline.
This is freakishly impossible.
And here come
the jugglers are so lame.
Yeah, they take a lot of damage down, but I find I just had enough to make it. Here's a tough part. Making these, you have to each rope is a different distance from the other rope, so you have to time each jump differently. So I just ended up saving state on every rope eventually. I wanted to showcase a couple deaths and show you where my save states go.
Right.
Just there, the rope, yeah. They're all on the rope here, so we'll just skip on by. Yeah, this is the one that's, I think, the hardest in the game, for sure. So if you can manage to get it to be the last one on the board, you could try it as many times as you want without gaming over. So if you do want to try to beat this in one go, make sure that you don't try this while there are too many other levels on the screen, or else you won't be able to get your free man very easily. I'll explain in the next video exactly how to farm free men when there are a few levels left. You can farm free men and avoid game over.
Yeah.
At least like one in 50 times that might fuck up, but like 49 out of 50 times you can avoid getting a game over if there's just one or two levels left in the game, and I'll talk about that later. We're almost done this level. Timing your jumps over these weird looking doggy clowns isn't that tough. You just got to not jump while you're on the trampoline to do a small jump and change your phase with them, and then press jump on the trampoline to jump high. Anyway, we're done with this level, and we're done with this episode, which means there's only one level left until we're done with this game.
Thank goodness for that one.
Alright, I want to thank Bo Cash Royale, and all you guys. Thanks again. See you. Stay tuned for the death reel and the final episode.
Happy Thanksgiving! He's a pig, 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 he's a pig. Yeah.
spider pig does whatever a spider pig does. Can he swing from a whip? No, he can't. He's a pig. Spider pig does whatever a spider pig does. Can he swing from a whip? No, he can't. He's a pig. 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 He's a pig.
He's a pig. He's a pig. He's a pig.